Who's up? Who's down?
All right, I'm going to start on this one. Who's up? I have Holly Rowe. I mean, this past weekend saw Rowe handle sideline duties for a men's hoops game in Arizona, a women's basketball game in South Carolina, a softball game at Florida State. This isn't about her travel schedule. That's something that always irritates both of us. But I'm emphasizing that because she has clearly assumed the number one role as ESPN's go-to college reporter in football and basketball. That's a spot that was once occupied by Maria Taylor, of course. And I just think that's worth mentioning.
Yeah, Tom Rinaldi also opened up some slots for her when he went to Fox Sports. All right, my who's up is NBC and the Olympics. Wait,
what? Andrew, they just had the least watched Olympics of all time.
It's called Who's Up, and the only direction they can go is up. Well, that was a disaster. The NBC Olympics was a disaster. We said from the beginning, this was a Bill Belichick on the Cincinnati Olympics, try to get to Paris, get past it. It was as bad as we thought, maybe worse, ratings all-time low. They had the COVID restrictions, the situation with the Chinese government, and the diplomatic boycotting of the games by the U.S. Everything was against it. And then the time difference, no American stars really doing that well. And it was a total disaster. So my who's up, tongue firmly in cheek, is NBC in the Olympics. But I will say this, we're going to have this as a topic. I don't think the long-term story is as bad as some people like, oh, the Olympics over. We'll get into that in a little bit. But they're my who's up because that's the only direction they can go. All right. Who's down for me? Phil Mickelson.
Weeks in a row for Phil Mickelson is being who's down, and he deserves it too. Let's hear it.
Yeah, last week you gave him the who's down. This week I give it the who's down. If you haven't heard his comments about why he's in bed with the Saudi Golf League, I mean, it's hard to miss him. He basically said that they're murderous people, they're bigots, et cetera, but he's doing it because he wants some leverage against the PGA Tour. I don't know if he's killed the Saudi Golf League before it started, but I kind of think it's hard for it to come back from it. It is an unbelievable blunder that will change the course of golf history. Phil Mickelson's comments and where it leaves him. It's a odd situation now.
Yeah, noteworthy to me too is just seeing people like Rory McIlroy going in. Phil's like an old like statesman of golf, and even people like McIlroy were just teeing off on him, which is an unintentional pun. My who's down, Adam Silver of the NBA. Silver has been commissioner of the NBA for about 8 years. He's had in that 8 year span, one of the longest honeymoons I've ever seen for a sports commissioner. He gets such positive press no matter what happens. And it's been an upward slide for him for 8 years. But this past weekend, during what was an otherwise successful NBA All-Star game, Silver had a couple of moments that I could have chosen from for the who's down. He is out of step with his views of reporter access in the locker rooms. But he's who's down here for me because he's overseeing a dunk contest. Let's listen to Dwayne Wade describe it on TNT.
This dunk contest was a six.
Man, is there a five?
This was a six.
I'll tell you what. We always have an off year. Even LeBron James have off games.
That's true. Okay.
All right.
Don't Obi Toppin wins the AT&T Slam Dunk Competition. You brought
the six out of nine.
You brought your own.
I'm about to flip it. This dunk contest right here was a solid six.
Don't mess my dunk contest.
We haven't seen the viewership numbers yet, Andrew. I'm sure it rated well. NBA Saturday Night always rates well, but oof. I mean, Silver in the NBA, they have to make changes because it's not a good look to have one of your premier events become the object of ridicule. And the dunk contest was ridiculed all over my social feeds on Saturday night.